hunger driven, knows PhD, and I have it tattooed on my arm. Poor, not meaning not able to afford things, you know, because, you know, I'm fortunate to be able to afford things, but it's poor in the sense of I'm not able to say, okay, I could retire tomorrow. Hungry in the sense of I want more. I'm not content with being drafted. I need to prove a lot of people wrong, and in that sense, I'm gonna stay hungry, you know, to do so. Driven. Haters drive me, you know, when people say that I can't, you know, it makes me want to show that I can. All those are spelled with K's.
By how long have you been working out here for?
Man, sounds like sixth grade. People never used to come here because, you know, this is the hood.
Where are we at right now?
Rotary Boys and Girls Club. What are we on, 19 and Spruce, I think. It's a good place to work out.
My name is Terrence Williams, born June 28th at 10:45 p.m., 1987.
I'm from Seattle, Washington, and this is the gym I grew up in, Rotary Boys and Girls Club in the Central District of Seattle.
I went to Redwood Beach High School. You know, home of, you know, Jamal Crawford, Nate Robinson, you know, Doug Christie, you know, guys like that. And I went there for the simple fact of, I think it's a great coach, you know, and Mike Badia, you know, coming up at that time, I feel like that was best for me. Nate's brother was kind of like, you know, my brother, my best friend. And, you know, he went there, so I kind of wanted to be a part of that. You know, I wanted to keep the legacy going there. So it kind of all just, you know, fell into place for me to go to Redwood Beach. It's a lot of distractions for the place that it's set in. You know, it's just like if a kid go to Garfield, you know, you're in the hood. You know, if you go to Redwood Beach, you're in the hood. So it's like, it's a distraction, but in the same sense, you gotta be focused. You know, my main focus was to get out of Redwood Beach and go somewhere else. You know, so yeah, it's a distraction as far as soon as you walk outside and you go up the street to Henderson. You know, it's a million, you know, people that's not doing stuff, you know, with their life there. So, you know, it kind of challenges you, you know, to stay on point, you know, in a sense. But I think with distractions, you know, makes you a better person. Because it'll tell you how can you focus. I would say a lot of people helped mentor me, you know, to get to where I am today. You know, we could start off with Jamal Crawford. You know, I feel like Jamal has helped me so much, you know, from when I was in sixth grade and I played him one-on-one, you know, for a root beer, up until this point. Brandon Roy helped me, and I would say Brandon Roy is like a brother, but he's like a long-lost brother. And I mean, what I mean by that is, when I first learned how to play basketball, he taught me. You know, I lived in West Seattle. I used to go across the street and play with him every day. Pause. But he was just a great influence on me because everything he was doing at Garfield at the time, I wanted that when I was a guy in high school. You know, he tried to go out of high school, didn't work, went to college, took care of business, and, you know, was drafted high. You know, definitely Nate Robinson, you know, Nate Daniel Cornelius Robinson, if you want to be exact.
I've been knowing T a long time, man. He was like seven.
He helped me out so much as far as coming from the same place, the same type of struggle.
Play basketball with my little brother, man. T's been a kid from the bottom. You know, made it out the hood.
Me staying at his house when I was younger, like to everything. So I knew when he got drafted, you know, it felt like that I got drafted.
It was for me, it was a joy to watch, you know, watch him go through his ups and downs, make it through college, go all 4 years, make it to the NBA, have a setback now, come back, prove himself to everybody, let him know that, you know, he's a good kid and he can play the game of basketball.
Who, Terrence Williams? That boy bad. Nah. Man, bro has it all, man. He just gotta put it all together at one time and he'll be good. He's ready to go though. Just know that.
So, you know, I think I look up to all three of them, you know, a lot. You know, they help Terrence Williams become T-Will, you know, today.
With the 11th pick in the 2009 NBA draft, the New Jersey Nets select Terrence Williams from the University of Louisville.
Coach Rick Pitino in the house. Of course, Terrence Williams, college coach at Louisville, 6'6", 213-pounder. Terrence Williams is the first senior selected in the 2009 NBA draft. We have to go 11 picks before a senior is selected. Seven guards, by the way, selected in the top 10 picks. At Louisville, he scored 12 points a game, almost 9 rebounds a game. He's a third-team All-American. Now, Terrence says...
Oh, this bad light is not for me. I close my eyes and imagine I'm home. I miss the days when life was simple. What if I never tried to follow that rainbow in search of the fire to gold?
How would you say the last 2 years of being in the NBA has gone for you? Was it what you thought?
It's been up and down. You know, it's great. It's great moments and it's bad times. You know, I think more so at the end of my rookie year, you know, I finally got to play basketball and figure out the speed of the game. You know, I actually did well, you know, for myself. And then my second year getting traded, you know, it was kind of hard for being on the team one day and the next day, you know, and not on that team anymore. So I think it's much as what I expected, you know, as far as learning that the NBA is a business. You know, you're on a team, but you really don't belong to that team. So you know, it's kind of tough.
We had to hear it. Home of Gary Payton, Sean Kemp, and Terrence Williams. Y'all feel me? In search of the fighter code.
Sometimes I try to do good, but I just can't be. It's hard to get myself to.
What's the lineup? What compares Seattle to other cities that have offered?
I would say that our lineup, you know, is great. As far as, you know, three guys I named with Nate Robinson, Jamal Crawford, Brandon Roy, Spencer Hawes is good, Aaron Brooks is good. You know, even though Isaiah is some miles south, I'm saying Isaiah isn't with Seattle. Isaiah Thomas is good. Martell West was good. I think it matched up fairly well with a lot of, you know, cities that feel like, you know, they're the basketball gurus of this. And I think we're willing to showcase that. You know, we're willing to travel, we're willing to have people come here and host a game. You know, at the end of the day, it's basketball. You know, it's not a shootout, you know, it's basketball. So I think we'll match up, you know, fairly well against other people.
Terrence Williams!
Is there a tomorrow? Yeah, we won. And her Beach Boys was in the building.
This is me, 24/7 and straight, raw, and uncut. You know, some people love it, some people hate it. The people that hate it, I love you. I think watching these, you guys want to watch the next one and the next one because you'll see a real person, you know, that give it to you straight. And a person that works out a lot, you know, a workaholic. So I think it'd be good, you know, stay tuned. You know, whether it's me, Nate, or Isaiah, it should be good stuff for you guys.